In this end of financial year inventory reconciliation video, we're going to look at how to finalise and release all inventory transactions, reconcile the cost of inventory with the account balance, and close financial periods in inventory. Let's start with finalising and releasing all inventory transactions. To do this, go to the Release IN Documents form. For those who release their inventory transactions as you go, this page will be blank and there's nothing you need to do here. But if you do see transactions listed here, like receipts, issues, kit assembly, transfers, and adjustments, go ahead and release them. If you receive an error when releasing any of these transactions, you can expand the error message and fix the transaction that will not release. It's recommended that you reconcile the value of your inventory by comparing the total cost balance on the inventory valuation report with the balance of the inventory asset account on the trial balance. If the two balances don't match, you'll need to review each transaction in the inventory and general ledger modules to find the mismatch so the balances can be corrected. Lastly, let's look at how to close financial periods in inventory. Go to the Close Financial Periods form. In the Company box of the selection area, select the company you want to close a financial period for. You can close any number of financial periods in more than one financial year by selecting the latest year in the 2-year box. Next, select the unlabeled checkbox in the row of the latest period you want to close. The periods preceding this period are automatically selected. Time to close the selected period. Either click Process or Process All to close all of the periods in the list. Once the period is closed, the system will remove the period ID from the list.